There are two constants in life, death and taxes, which also happens to be the name of a deck in Magic the Gathering. Death and Taxes is a deck archetype found traditionally in Legacy that uses a number of small, efficient white creatures in combination with a number of tax and resource denial effects and the artifact Aether Vial to control the pace of the game by taxing the opponent's resources while swinging in for incremental damage. Legacy is where the deck first rose to prominence. A version of the deck piloted by Thomas and Ed Voldsen won the Legacy Grand Prix in Strasbourg in 2013. That deck was based off another deck built by Andreas Petersen that was created to win a Fabled tournament where the prize was a Mox Pearl. Though the original deck has had some pieces that have fallen out of favor in recent times, the main shell of the deck hasn't changed too much over time. The three essential cards that make up the core of the deck are Thalia, Guardian of Thraben, Aether Vial, and Flicker Wisp. Thalia slows down non-creature spells with her taxing effect, and First Strike means she blocks and carries equipment well. Aether Vial lets you get around your own tax effect and gives you an uncounterable way to flash in creatures for a variety of different tricks like blocking and bringing in the next card. Flicker Wisp lets you perform a number of tricks like resetting other cards' counters or taking advantage of Enter the Battlefield effects, but also combines well with Aether Vial to flicker away an attacker or save a blocker. On top of that, Flicker Wisp also represents an evasive flying body. For other parts of the deck, Phyrexian Revoker, Avon Mind Sensor, Rashad in Port, and Wasteland are there to tax and deny the opponent's resources. Stoneforge Mystic and an equipment package including Batterskull and Umezawa's Jite create threats that play well with Mirran Crusader. Mother of Runes and Aganjo Castle provide protection for your creatures. And finally, a small combo involving Fiendhunter and Flicker Wisp, or Mangara of Korindor and Caracas to exile other threats. With either Fiendhunter or Mangara's effect on the stack, you could Aether Vial and Flicker Wisp to exile Fiendhunter or Mangara until end of turn. With either creature still in exile, their effects would resolve, exiling another creature or permanent. At the end of the turn, Fiendhunter or Mangara would then return to the battlefield from Flicker Wisp effect resolving. Mangara of Korindor can combo in a similar way by using Caracas to bounce him back to your hand while his effect is on the stack. Caracas can also be used to save a Thalia, Guardian of Thraben in a pinch. Although most of the deck has stayed the same, over time it has evolved and been customized to suit players' individual needs and playstyles, some opting to use Sarah Avenger or Brimaz, King of Oreskos, as attackers. Spirit of the Labyrinth, Sanctum Prelate, or Containment Priest for taxing and resource denial, and Sword of Fire and Ice or Sword of Light and Shadow have also found their way into the equipment package. Other players have started dipping into other colors like green for cards like Knight of the Reliquary, Kitchen Finks, and Quazali Pride Mage. Some dip into colorless and black for Thought Knot Seer, Wasteland Strangler, and Tide Hollow Sculler for a deck called Eldrazian Taxes. The deck has also been ported to Modern, where it could use cards like Ghost Quarter, Tectonic Edge, and Path to Exile to remove resources from the opponent, while synergizing with Leonin Arbiter to prevent the downside of those removal options. Recently, Zendikar Rising created a stir by adding Skyclave Aberration and Archon of Emyria, which have helped bolster the modern version of the deck. The deck's strength is in its balance between aggro and control. The attackers provide pressure by chipping away at the opponent's life total, while the disruption from taxation and resource denial leaves the opponent fighting a war on two fronts. Sneak and Show or Reanimator decks can struggle dealing with taxation and resource denial, while Caracas can absolutely ruin their game plan by bouncing Emrakul, Aeon's Torn, or Gristlebrand. The weakness of the deck is that it struggles against creature removal, especially board wipes or similar effects that deal with a number of small creatures like Terminus, Toxic Deluge, Dread of Night, or Izzet Static Caster. The deck also has difficulty in dealing with bigger creatures like Gurmag Angler or Delver of Secrets. Artifact Hate shutting down or removing Aether Vial also hamstrings the deck. The deck's intricacies and play patterns make for an almost infinite skill ceiling in piloting. This has led to many creators making very specific guides dealing exactly what and when to sideboard in almost every matchup and how to play. I'll link their guides in the description below since they provide more fantastic insight than I can provide.